Hey folks, welcome back. We're here for you again and bringing the coolest vibes of NBA for you all. Devonte Kakok, much impressed for the South Bay Lakers in the NBA G League this season. After signing a two-way contract with the Lakers, Kakok spent the season with South Bay due to the Lakers' depth in the front court. LA remained healthy enough that they never needed his talents. Kakok looks like he's on track for a productive NBA career as a role player. It would be another find for the Lakers' underrated scouting department. Let's move forward with our video and have a look at the top 10 things you didn't know about Devonte Kakok. So, let's begin. But before we proceed further, if you haven't yet subscribed to the channel, do hit that subscribe button so that you won't be missing out on any future NBA content. Number 10. Birth and career. Born on October 8, 1996, Devonte Calvin Kakok grew up in Riverdale playing football as a youth, mainly on the offensive line. He first began playing basketball in 8th grade after he fractured his wrist, ending his football season. Kakok admits being terrible at first, but joined his high school varsity team after a 7-inch growth spurt as a sophomore. As a senior at Alpharetta High School, he averaged 22 points and 12 rebounds per game and led the team to a regional title. As a freshman at UNC Wilmington, Kakok came off the bench to average 3.3 points per game. He accomplished this extremely high percentage, the highest ever, by mainly shooting within a range of about 2 feet from the basket and only taking one jump shot all year on the 29-6 Seahawks team. Coming into his senior season, Kakok was named to the preseason first team All-CAA. After going undrafted in the 2019 NBA Draft, Kakok signed an Exhibit 10 contract with the Los Angeles Lakers to play in the 2019 NBA Summer League. On October 21, 2019, Kakok was waived by the Lakers. He was then added to the roster of the South Bay Lakers of the NBA G League. On August 13, 2019, he made his NBA debut for the Lakers, scoring 6 points on 3 of 6 shooting and grabbing 5 rebounds in a 136-122 loss to the Sacramento Kings. Number 9. Commanding player. Kakok can bring second-chance points off the bench within minutes. He can rebound on each side of the court and has shown that he's a commanding player that the LA front office took notice of during the Summer League. Kakok mostly flew under the radar until he filled the stat sheet during the California Classic Summer League in Sacramento while coming off the bench. Most of the attention heading into the summer was focused on second-round pick Talen Horton-Tucker and two-way contract player Zach Lavelle Jr., as the Lakers were low on draft picks and heavy on undrafted signings. But Kakok made himself known by averaging 11.8 points, 9 rebounds, and 1.2 assists and 2 steals per game during the summer while coming off the bench in all but 3 games. Number 8. Rebound. Although Kakok is below the league's 6'11 average height for centers, his ability to rebound allows him to make up for some of the vertical deficiencies. During his last season with UNC Wilmington, Kakok averaged 12.3 rebounds a game for the NCAA's second best average. To put that in perspective, Zion Williamson, the 2019 number 1 overall draft pick, was number 44 on the list with 8.9 rebounds a game. Just like Kakok, Williamson is also listed at 6'7". Sure, Kakok is older than Williamson by 3 years, so he's definitely had the extra time to work on rebounding techniques, but nonetheless, Kakok's numbers on the glass are impressive. Number 7. Defensively, Kakok is not where he needs to be. As a rebounding specialist with a minimal offensive game, Kakok needs to develop into at least a solid defender. He needs to learn how to contest shots without fouling. He's only going to see the floor as a big in the NBA. If he can't stay out of foul trouble in the G League, he definitely won't be able to in the NBA. It's challenging to be good at contesting shots at the rim in the NBA at Kakok's size, but not impossible. Even if it can't be a strength, it needs to be a neutral area for him. Just working on not fouling while making the shot as difficult as possible will be tremendous for him. Number 6. Dedication. The growth spurt helped. Kakok grew 7 inches below his freshman and sophomore years and started for the varsity team after that. He transferred to Alpharetta High on the other side of Atlanta, and as a senior, he averaged 22 points and 12 rebounds, leading the Raiders to a regional title. But how did he go from 3.3 points in his freshman year at UNCW to 80% last season? No other qualified player in the country averaged 70% and finished on the edge of the top 15. It starts with a devoted dedication to the restricted area. Kakok attempted 230 shots last season, just one was a jump. The outer limit of his range was 2 feet at best. Part of that was by design. The Seahawks went 29-6 before losing to Virginia in the first round of the tournament, on the strength of four solid guards who all averaged above 33% from three. And why step out when you can do this? Keep yourself tuned in as we discover five more amazing facts with you all. Hope you guys are enjoying the video, and if you've yet not subscribed to the channel, do it now in order to make sure that you don't miss out on any future NBA content from now on. Number 5. NCAA record. It's hard to use any other word when you watch Kakok bust his tail to get into the proper position for every loose ball. He's no one-trick pony either. Kakok set the NCAA record for field goal percentage in 2016-17, making 80% of his shots. Sure, it was mostly layups and dunks, and his usage rate was rather low, but do you realize how many thousands of players have met that description over the years without coming anywhere close to making 4 out of every 5 field goal attempts? And Kakok is modest when asked about his spot in the record books. Number 4. Footwork confidence. Kakok regularly does an excellent job of knowing what to do after snagging the offensive rebound. If he's around the rim without two opposing bigs crowding him, he's able to finish with a strong putback dunk. However, if the crowd is by him, he has the awareness to go out and pass the ball out to one of his teammates. Another way that he's able to shine inside the paint is through working magic in the low post on either the left or right block. In either area, Kakok exhibits confidence with how he's able to footwork to create separation from his opponent and get a better look at the rim. That footwork is also beneficial when he's deciding to score from the angle by being able to put up hook shots, position his feet forward to make a mid-range attempt, or take a fadeaway jumper. Number 3. Pick and rolls. He was more than willing to go out and guard the perimeter, whether that came through hedging on pick and rolls or just switching onto guards. While the quality of guards in the CAA might not be the highest, it was definitely impressive to see the 6'7", 240-pound forward being able to utilize his frame and quick feet to prevent the opposing player from getting a clean shot or drive to the rim. Kakok's quick feet has also allowed him to be pretty solid help defender, as he can expeditiously get to a certain area on the court in an attempt in insisting to make a stop. Number 2. Developing offensively. Devonte Kakok led the South Bay Lakers in scoring at 19.4 points per game on a 65.9% field goal shooting. The UNC Wilmington alumni never averaged more than 17.7 per contest in his 4 college seasons. In his 2 highest scoring campaigns, he failed to reach the 60% shooting clip as well. That is extremely difficult to do in your first season in the G League, and Kakok deserves a lot of credit for the work he's put in. He understands his game and where it stands right now. Not only is he not hurting his team by taking bad shots, but he also has an understanding of where he needs to improve offensively. He has been recognized to be a useful player and upside to be a pretty good contributor. Number 1. Cleans the glass. Kakok's greatest strength coming into the NBA was undoubtedly his rebounding. As a 6'7" big, some question how well his glass cleaning would translate. In the G League, he didn't just display himself as a capable rebounder. Instead, he dominated the boards on a nightly basis, averaging 11.9 per game in a bit under 24 minutes per game. Playing against stronger NBA opponents will require continued training and development, but Kakok's instincts and hustle are where they need to be. NBA teams will always value rebounding, and being an ace glass cleaner holds excellent value. As he gets stronger, physically, Kakok will round out his rebounding game to the point of being desired by NBA clubs. To push that current plateau, the 6'7" forward will need to use his time with the South Bay Lakers to continue progressing as a shooter and show more of his work as a facilitator. So what do you guys think? Will he be able to do that and eventually land a guaranteed NBA deal after the 2019-20 season opens? Let us know your answers in the comment section down below. Hope you guys are enjoying the video, and thumbs up if you liked it, and do hit that subscribe button so that you won't be missing out on any interesting videos from now on.